devastation in Ha'apai after Cyclone Ian has left thousands of people homeless. Families in affected areas have lost everything.
We'll talk to our reporter John Pulu in a moment, but first he takes us to Ha'apai to see what's being done to help people get back on their feet.
If a picture paints a thousand words, then these images would make a book. Nothing and no one escaping Ian's might. It's been a month since the cyclone, and Alicia Kao and her family are still struggling to live day to day. Like so many here, they've lost everything.
I lost my washing machine, freezer, and some of my tupper, and some of my documents, like passport and birth certificate of my family.
The family of six couldn't all fit inside this temporary shelter, so their vehicle was transformed into another room. For now, this is home.
The main thing I need is a shelter for us first, before the other things, because I know the shelter is collect us as a family.
The Ha'apai Islands are home to around 6,000 people. More than 800 homes have been left in tatters in Ian's wake. Some villagers find refuge in their local church hall as they piece their lives back together. The rebuild is already underway. The once bustling business centre in Bangai is now filled with workers and machines clearing the rubble. And while the city's getting patched up, aid has been flowing in from all over the world.
We're on our way to Whakakai, where transportation to these remote islands is a bit more difficult, but today we're bringing more relief to over 170 people who have suffered from Cyclone Ian.
Primary school students in Whakakai have relocated to an alternative classroom as the cyclones wiped out their entire school. Today, boxes of stationery and learning equipment are specially delivered to them to help lift their spirits.
Everybody's still depressed. So we want them to get to school, join an environment where they can share with their classmates and the teachers as well.
There's a sigh of relief here in Ha'apai. Containers have arrived with donations from families overseas. There's water, non-perishable food, and even shelter. Enough for families here to get by.
Yeah. As aid trickles in, there's also a steady flow of criticism about its distribution. Many here say help is taking too long to reach those who need it the most.
I think it's too slow because we already get a donation from churches. I think the government is the other first one to stand up and help their people or their country.
The Tongan government is satisfied with their response plan. Their aim is to get people out of tents and into homes before the end of the year.
If we have to borrow, we would have to do that.
Doesn't that mean we'll be more in debt?
But if it's for the sake of the people, I'd rather do it.
For Alicia and her family, life continues. They're thankful for all the help.
I think maybe more than 5 or 10 years to fix the house, unless the government help us to build the house.
Thank you for joining us in our studio today, John. Now, that must have been really hard for you to see firsthand, seeing as your family's from Ha'apai.
Yeah, Maloi Tau Maipungpungini, Tom and Marama, thank you very much. My father's from the village of Holopeka, which is not far from the capital city in Ha'apai. And it's, you know, I've been to Ha'apai twice now, and I think this is one trip that I'll never forget, going back home to see the devastation. It's so unreal what Mother Nature can do to, you know, paradise. So this is something I'll never forget.
What was the biggest image that you went away with?
I think for me, as you saw in my story, I went to visit a school on a remote island, which is Kauai, and I was with the Ministry of Education. They were delivering stationery to these kids who have been, using an alternative classroom. And to see their faces when they're getting like a tent, a bag full of goodies, you know, their faces just light up. And, you know, for me, that's something I'll never forget as well. You know, they sing and they clap. It's relief for these kids.
So what else can people in New Zealand do to help? Is there more we can do right now? What do people need?
Yeah, being that I've been on the ground and I've seen the devastation, Marama, I'm asking everyone at home to donate and see what you can do, clothes, but money also to people like Oxfam, Red Cross. These guys are on the ground ASAP as soon as the cyclone hit, so that's one way of helping.
Places people can drop off things, the containers, are there local drop-off points?
Yeah, so there's been containers. I know there's down in Katikati, there's the Tonga community in Auckland, and also down in Christchurch, from my understanding. So there's still relief work going on. So we'll put it up on our Tangata Pasifika website for people to follow. But money is a big help, and it can go a long way in the kingdom.
Okay, thank you, John.
Mālo apito.